Trend Cinema presents six sports fans who took it too far. Spectating at a sports game can be an extremely fun and rewarding event. However, passion runs high in many of these diehard fans. Today, we will be looking at six fans whose emotions triggered them to do illegal, invasive, and disrespectful things in the heat of the moment. In this first clip, we have hundreds of fans who decide to storm the pitch before the football match is over. The horde of fans who charge the pitch is too massive for security personnel to hold back, forcing them to pause the game. Other fans in the crowd begin booing at this frolicsome disruption, and we hear the man filming expressing his utmost frustration. When a whistle blows in the NBA, all players on the court must stop what they are doing for the referee to make the call. Here we have a sneaky fan who thought it would be funny to blow a whistle when the opposing team was about to score and give an advantage to their own team. This incident threw both teams into confusion, prompting an investigation, and we hear the announcers tell fans, if you have a whistle, swallow it.
Double team it inside, jury off. That ball's loose. What happened? Breakaway.
You know, Corver slams down
too.
Thought they heard a whistle.
I heard
down
a whistle.
There.
Didn't
the
you hear
players,
a whistle?
Yeah, they're saying that maybe someone in the stands had a whistle.
One of the redcoats going up and talking to a fan or two, but you know what? Dan Roberts, the house PA announcer, making that announcement. If you have a whistle, swallow it.
This next fan brutally assaults this NFL player on the opposing team when he is attempting to catch the football. The fan oversteps into the field of play, attacking the player, and nearly tears off the face mask. Immediately following, one of the home team players runs over to give a shake of approval and celebrate with the fan over this likely illegal action. Yikes.
For the force trying to take it back, taking it back to the house. He's got it. Oh, he gets grabbed by a fan. I'm pretty sure that's not legal. I've never seen this before.
Well, that's taken.
Look
you
at
can
this.
Keep the football, but yet you got to stay out of the field of play, and he about rips the face mask.
Well, there's two calls there. Face mask. Illegal use of the hands.
Yeah, they're going to penalize Jacksonville for this and put the ball on the 20.
In this following clip, we have a mascot in the crowd who has a sign that reads, "I'm a loser," in block letters, which triggers another fan of the opposing team in the crowd. When the mascot makes his way down to court level, he is instantly charged upon and attacked by this upset fan. The two become entangled in a fight and must be torn apart by security. Next, we have a hockey player in the penalty box approached by some spectators who begin yelling offensive things and taunting him to the point where he takes his water bottle and squirts the water all over these fans, triggering them to break down the barrier. The announcer yells, "Watch the lawsuit," as referees step in to break up the brawl.
Tried to squirt water all over these guys behind him. That's when you need the Gatorade, about 9-1 with the syrup. That'll straighten those guys out.
Now you've had.
Let him in! Let him in the box!
Whoa!
All right! Watch the lawsuit, Ty! Watch the lawsuit! Kevin Collins, he's broken up
is something to be said for adults who snatch items that sports players are trying to hand over to children. Here we have a woman at an MLB game who interferes and actually takes a baseball that was tossed to the little girl out of her hands. This woman proceeds to celebrate her achievement, acting like she did not just steal it from a child, and celebrates with her friends. However, we know the truth.
She took the ball. Juan Miranda tried to give it to the little gal, and she took it from her.
Took it right from her.
And that was last Friday.
Just beyond wrong.
Oh, bless her heart. We sent a ball down.
Here are some additional cringe-packed honorable mentions from like-minded adults.
Making a souvenir for somebody. Bill Venable was still playing. One of the youngest base coaches you'll find.
Well, the little girl gets boxed out. And look at the face.
Oh.
We're going to get
Dan Bylsma trying to throw it to that kid up there in the red. Look at this. The gentleman grabs it right out and puts it in his pockets.
And check this out. He's trying to give it to her, and this lady in the orange shirt is trying to take it from him. Nope, nope, nope. Yeah. I don't know about the lady in the orange shirt.
No. She didn't have the sign.
How great.
Thank you so much for watching. Tap one of the videos on screen for another amazing video.